How many times have you found yourself staring at a blank screen or deleting hours of work because the good ideas just wouldn't come? We've all been there, and it's a massive struggle to try to be creative on demand, but it's part of the process when people are paying you to design. What if I told you there was a way to conquer that problem for good? The answer is the swipe file, and it's long been the designer's best kept secret for getting rid of creative block and staying productive. Unlike all those random folders of screenshots and unorganized chaos inside your bookmarks, a swipe file keeps everything organized and makes it really easy to find exactly what you need right when you need it. In today's video, I'm going to show you how you can create a swipe file using the free version of Notion. Here, you're going to be able to grab screenshots or all kinds of information and tag it so that you can easily search, filter, and find it later when you need it. If that sounds interesting to you, then stick around and let's get started. So we're going to start here in a completely blank Notion page, and I'm just going to call this swipe file. Now, all we need to add to this page is an inline database. So if you start searching for inline or database, you'll see this database inline. So we'll go ahead and add that to our page. Now, we're going to need a much bigger area to work with here. So I'm going to go ahead and use this as a full page so I can see the entire thing at once. And we'll just call this database swipe file, even though it's kind of redundant. All right. So the first thing we need to do is organize what data we're going to collect in here. So by default, it's going to have a name. The way Notion's databases work, you have to have this as like a primary record. So we're just going to leave that be. Now we will want to leave our tags because we're going to make use of those. But I want to go ahead and add another field here, which is going to be our URL field. For some of these swipe files we grab, I want to go ahead and grab the URL where they came from in case I want to visit them later on. So we'll go ahead and just add that URL in there for now. I know we're going to use some others here later, so we'll just go ahead and stop at that point. Now, I don't want to view this in a table layout. I actually want to view this as a gallery. So I'm going to click on this table here and hit Edit View, and we're going to change this layout from table over to gallery. And this is going to give us some cards to look at, which is a lot easier when we're dealing with visuals. So we'll go ahead and delete out these first three that it put in there by default so we can start adding some of our own. So the first thing I'm going to do is go to one of the sites I want to collect some inspiration from, and I really like this hero section. So I'm going to go ahead and grab my screen capture tool, and I'm going to go ahead and take a screenshot of this hero section. Now that automatically puts this screenshot on my clipboard, so I can just go back in here into my swipe file, click new, and paste it in by hitting Control V, and it's going to paste it in as the content of this swipe file item. Now, I want to go ahead and add some tags to this. So the tags are a really important part of how you organize all this information inside your swipe file. This means that later on down the road, you can come back and find exactly what you're looking for by filtering through all the different tags you give it. So for this, we might say something like hero, since I know this is a hero design, and we might say light mode because we might want to look through light mode and dark mode things. Now this tag list is going to grow over time, so I like to just start out a swipe file by just adding things as I need them, and it will auto suggest as you start typing things. Like if I start typing L-I-G-H-T, you can see that light mode comes up, so you'll easily know in the future whether you already have this tag in there or not. So like I said, from the beginning, I would just do this organically and add things as you need them. Now for this one, I want to go ahead and collect the URL so I can go back here, copy this URL and paste it in here to my URL space. Now we can go ahead and give this a title. So I could call this Mailer Send Hero, which would be an appropriate title since this is the hero section of the Mailer Send website. Later on, I'm going to talk about why I don't usually give these titles, but we'll go ahead and do this as best practice for now. Let's go ahead and take a screenshot of another site. Here on this Rebump site, I like the way they did this how it works section with these little arrows that kind of show you step by step how this works. So I'm going to go ahead and grab my screen grab tool again, take a screenshot of that, click new, paste this in here, and think about what tags I might want to give this. So these are kind of like a card design. I know cards are going to be something that I take a lot of inspiration from, so we'll go ahead and give this the tag of card. We could also give this something like steps, which is something that I'll use quite a bit in the same kind of context, like the 1, 2, 3 type thing. And we'll go ahead and give this the light mode tag as well, since we know this is a light mode design. Again, I'll just go ahead and grab that URL and we can paste it in here in case we ever need to go find that site again. And we could call this Rebump Steps. So now that we got a couple items here inside of our swipe file, let's talk about how we can customize this look a little bit more. I'm going to go here and click these three dots And the first thing I want to change is going into the layout here and changing the card size from medium to large. Since we're dealing with visuals and my eyesight is terrible, I like to make these a little bit bigger so they're just easier to browse through. The other thing that we can change on here is what properties are shown underneath the thumbnail. So obviously I want that thumbnail to show, but I don't really need the name. The name isn't something that I'm going to be looking for or searching by, so I'm going to go ahead and click this little eyeball icon, and that will get rid of the name. However, tags are something that I'm definitely going to want to see. So we'll go ahead and click the eyeball icon there to turn the tags on, and you can see now these tags are showing in the bottom of all of these cards, which is perfect. Now here's where you need to take a second to think about your own personal use case for a swipe file. Of course, I design websites, so website design is something I'm going to want to grab some screenshots for. But I have some more creative things I like to grab inspiration from too. So what I want to do here is go back into one of these cards. We'll just go ahead and open one up. And I'm going to click in here to add a new property. We're going to call this type. Here I'll go ahead and click on type, and I'm going to change the type of property it is. The tags property that we use is a multi-select, meaning we can add multiple tags to each one of our swipe file items. However, on this type, I just want to do a select type. This means that I'm just going to add one thing to this. So how I'm going to do this is I'm going to add some options here. So one could be website design, which is all we've grabbed so far. I'll go ahead and hit enter. But I also want to collect inspiration for YouTube. Obviously, I'm making a YouTube video here. I will often grab thumbnails or titles that I think are a good idea. So I'm going to have the type of YouTube. I also do a lot of copywriting. So I'm going to go ahead and add copywriting as another type of swipe I might want to grab. Now I'm going to go ahead and grab this type and move it up to the top so it's above the tags. And I can go into this one and set it as the type of web design. And same thing here for my mailer send hero. We'll go ahead and add that as a web design type as well. Now, so far, I only have website design stuff in here. So let's grab some other types of inspiration. We'll go to Seth's blog, and I'll go ahead and maybe just grab all this text from his blog since this is going to be a copywriting swipe. We'll go in here and just paste in all this content here. And we'll give this the type of copywriting, and I might give this the tag of newsletter since this is the kind of thing I might use as inspiration for a newsletter I write. We'll go ahead and close that. Let's go to youtube.com, and I'll just grab one of these thumbnails here. And we'll go back into our swipe file, paste this in, change the type to YouTube, and change this tag to thumbnail. We didn't have that in there, so I can go ahead and add it in, and now I have a YouTube thumbnail swipe. The reason I want to create these different types and tags is because I can create different views of my swipe file, so it's easier for me to see exactly what I'm looking for. So here you're seeing we have this gallery view. It was just named gallery by default. Let's go ahead and rename that. We'll call this all swipes. Since this has no filters on it, it's just going to show every one of our swipe files. But what I want to do is create a specific one where I can just look at my design elements. So I'm going to right click here and I'm going to hit duplicate. Now we'll change this name from All Swipes 1 to Design. And we'll go in here to our filter in the type. We're going to change this to Website Design. Now this view has filtered out everything that's not a website design. So you can see the copywriting and the YouTube that we grabbed that were here in our All Swipes file are gone when we go to this Design tab because this is only going to show us design items. We'll go ahead and duplicate this. And let's create another one for YouTube, which is another one of our types. And we'll go in here to our filter, and instead of website design, we're going to change this to YouTube. And now it's only showing us our YouTube swipes. So I would recommend going through and doing this for all your different types of swipes, or by however you want to organize and filter through your information. Now I wouldn't go too crazy and start creating a new view for every one of your tags inside of your database, since you're going to have dozens, if not hundreds of different tags. Really what you want to focus on here is just creating a few views that you know you're going to use pretty frequently. Here I've gone ahead and just populated the swipe file with a bunch of different screenshots. Now in here you can see we're in our design tab, which is showing just our website design elements, but you can see each one of these has a different set of tags on it. Let's say I'm just looking for some inspiration for cards. Well, what I can do is just click on this little filter icon, which you'll see in the top right corner, and then we can go in here under tags and search for cards. Now, if I go ahead and check that box, now this has filtered it down to just all the swipes we've taken that are under design and have the tag of card. So this way I could go through all this inspiration as I'm working out my different design ideas. Once you're done with it, all you have to do is open that up and close it out, and now you go back to all of your design elements. The great thing about creating your own swipe file is it is completely personalized to your taste. When you get stuck or just need a little boost, you can always just scroll through your swipe file and find the spark of inspiration that gets you going. In fact, just yesterday I went through my swipe file when I was stuck on a client project, found a really cool hero design, and did my own spin on it to create something unique for my client. Your swipe file will continue to get better and better the more you use it, but the key is consistency. And this is the reason I often won't give my swipes a title, simply because I'm never really using them. There's no point to go in there and take the extra time to add that information in there. And this is why I'd caution you from putting too much information inside of your swipe file. The more information you try to collect on each one of your swipes, the bigger the barrier of entry becomes to putting all those swipes inside of your file. For me, it's all about making this as convenient as possible. I've bookmarked my swipe file and I try to keep it as an open tab at all times. This way, I'm only 1 or 2 seconds away from adding something cool I found into my swipe file. Because no matter how well-intentioned you are, even if you say you're gonna do it later, chances are you never get back to it. I hope this was helpful and inspired you to create a swipe file of your own. I promise you that if you've struggled with design in the past, this is one of those tools that's really going to make it easier for you. It's not about copying other designs, it's about getting inspiration. And having your own personalized file of everything that inspires you is a great way to get a jump start on your next project. If you've enjoyed this video, I'd really appreciate a thumbs up. And if you want to make sure to catch the next one, hit subscribe and we'll see you then.